हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फ्रैक्शंस, राइट? इन स्कूल्स यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट, यू हैड ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट फ्रैक्शंस। नाउ इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू जस्ट रिवाइज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। नाउ फ्रैक्शन, फ्रैक्शन इज रिटन एज ए अपॉन बी in this form, right? This A is known as a numerator, B is known as a denominator, right? Numerator and denominator. Now this fraction bar, this is known as a fraction bar, separates the numerator and denominator. It is a symbol for division, right? This A upon B means A divided by B. Okay, so in general fraction is written as A upon B, where A is a numerator and B is a denominator. Okay, then polynomial fractions, what we mean by a polynomial fractions? So polynomial fractions is a rational expression. Okay, it is a rational expressions which is same as the fraction in which both the numerator and denominator are polynomials. Okay, in numerator polynomial term, denominator also there is a polynomial term. Okay, so polynomial means polynomial expressions or polynomial fractions means polynomial terms in numerator and polynomial terms in denominator. Okay, in numerator and denominator, if both places there is a polynomial terms, then that is known as a polynomial fraction. Clear? So here it is written in the form of px upon qx, where divisible of 0 is not allowed. Okay, that means qx should not be equal to 0. Okay, here numerator and denominator both are having polynomials, both are having polynomials terms. Now the next is proper fraction and improper fraction concept. Now the rational function, okay, means polynomial fraction is known as a proper fraction when the degree of polynomial in numerator is less than the degree of polynomial in denominator. Okay, degree of polynomial, okay, in numerator is less than the degree of polynomial in denominator. Okay, strictly less than, then the given fraction is a proper fraction. And if the degree of polynomial in numerator is greater than or equal to, okay, greater than or equal to of the degree of polynomial in denominator, then that fraction is known as a improper fraction. Okay, so fraction, first concept is fraction, second concept is proper and improper fractions. So proper fraction means degree of polynomial in numerator is simply less than the degree of polynomial in denominator. Improper fraction means degree of polynomial in numerator is either greater than or equal to degree of polynomial in denominator. Okay, now see the example. First example, x plus 2 upon x square minus x plus 1, right? In numerator, degree of x is 1. In denominator, degree of polynomial is 2, right? Highest exponent is 2, right? So numerator, in numerator, exponent is 1, right? So degree of polynomial in numerator is 1. Degree of polynomial in denominator is 2, right? So that means numerator is less than the denominator, right? Strictly less than. So therefore x plus 2 upon x square minus x plus 1 is a proper fraction. Clear? See the second one is x square minus 3x plus 1 upon x raised to 5 minus 3x. Right? Here in numerator degree of polynomial is 2. Right? In denominator degree of polynomial is 5. Right? So 2 is strictly less than the 5. Since 2 is strictly less than the 5, therefore this is a proper fraction. Clear? See the next example. X upon x raised to 8 plus 1. Here degree of polynomial in numerator is 1. Degree of polynomial in denominator is 8. Now 1 is less than the 8, right? So this fraction is a proper fraction. Okay, next example, this one, degree of x in numerator is 7, right? Degree of polynomial in denominator is 9, right? So 7 is less than the 9, so this fraction is a proper fraction. Clear? Proper fraction means degree of x in numerator should be less than the degree of x in denominator. Okay, highest degree of x in numerator should be less than the highest degree of x in denominator. Okay, now for improper fraction, see the example. First example, degree of polynomial in numerator is 3. Degree of polynomial in denominator is 1. So 3 is greater than 1. Right, that means numerator is greater than the denominator. If numerator is greater than the denominator, then fraction is improper fraction. Okay, see the next second example. Degree of polynomial in numerator is 7. Degree of polynomial in denominator is 7. So numerator is equal to denominator, right? So therefore this is not a proper fraction. So improper fraction. See the third example. Degree of polynomial in numerator is 5, right? Highest power of x is 5. In denominator, highest degree of x is 2. So definitely 5 is greater than 2. That means numerator is greater than denominator. So this is not a proper fraction. So this is known as the improper fraction. Next example. In this example, degree of x in numerator is 8. Degree of x in denominator is 3. Right? So since 8 is less than 3. Right? So numerator is 8 is greater than 3. Sorry, 8 is greater than 3. So that means numerator is greater than denominator, right? And therefore this is a improper fraction. This is not a proper fraction. Okay, so class, fraction, polynomial fraction means fraction in which numerator and denominator both are having polynomials. Okay, if in numerator and denominator there are polynomials, then that is known as a polynomial fraction. Okay, then in fraction we have two types of fractions, proper fraction and improper fraction. So fraction is known as a proper fraction if the degree of polynomial in numerator is strictly less than the degree of polynomial in denominator, then that fraction is known as a proper fraction. Okay, and if degree of polynomial in numerator is either greater than or equal to the degree of polynomial in denominator, then that fraction is known as a improper fraction. Okay, now just identify proper and improper fractions. Okay, so first, degree of polynomial in numerator is 2, right? Degree of polynomial in denominator. So first we have to multiply this, right? So after multiplication we get the 2x square, right? We get the x square as the highest term, right? So highest exponent will be 2 in numerator. Degree is 2, right? Degree of polynomial is 2. In denominator also degree of polynomial is 2. So numerator is equal to denominator. Therefore, this is a improper fraction. Okay, first one is not a proper fraction. This one is improper fraction. Next, second example. See, the degree of polynomial in numerator is 4. Degree of polynomial in denominator is 3, right? So second one, since numerator is greater than the denominator, therefore second one is a improper fraction. Okay, it is not a proper fraction. Third, degree of polynomial in numerator. So degree, highest degree of x in numerator is 1. Okay, only x is given. So power of x is 1. Degree of x is 1. Then in denominator, after multiplication, we get x into 2x, right? In denominator, we get x into 2x. So 2x cube. So highest power of x will be 3. Okay, so in numerator highest power is 1, in denominator highest power of x is 3, right? So strictly numerator is less than denominator, so this one is a proper fraction. Okay, fourth example, degree of polynomial in numerator is 1, degree of polynomial in denominator is 2. So that means numerator is less than denominator, right? So fourth is a proper fraction. Okay, now the fifth one, highest degree of x in numerator is 1, in denominator highest degree of x is 2, right? X into x will be x square. So highest degree of x in denominator is 2. Now 1 is less than 2, numerator is less than denominator, so fifth one is a proper fraction. Okay, sixth, degree of polynomial in numerator is 3, degree of polynomial in denominator is also 3, so numerator is equal to denominator and therefore this is not a proper fraction, so improper fraction. Okay, so class, it is very important to identify the fraction, whether the given fraction is proper or improper. Okay, now to identify, it is very important to check the exponent of variable. Okay, find the highest power or highest degree of variable. Okay, in numerator and denominator. And on that basis, we can define whether the given polynomial fraction is proper or improper. Clear? So with this, I'm concluding my video. So in next video, we can see the further part of partial fractions. So thank you, class.